بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم، الحمد لله رب العالمين، والصلاة والسلام على رسول الله وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين. أما بعد، السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. Welcome everyone to the daily reminder and our discussion surrounding Salah and its importance in the 21st century. My dear brothers and sisters, in life, it's important that we are dynamic in that which we do, so that we do not become bored. When we do something in a static way, we end up becoming bored. And Salah teaches us this all-important concept of being dynamic. For in the worship of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, through Salah, we see that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has commanded us to worship Him whilst standing during some periods, and then to worship Him whilst bowing during some periods, and then to worship Him through prostration during some periods, and then to worship Him through sitting during some periods. We worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala using invocations, using recitation from the book of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And even in that, we see the Sharia teaching us how to be dynamic in that. For in Salah, we're not encouraged to read just one surah, but rather different surah during the different salawat. Even when we look at the invocations at the beginning of Salah, we find that Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was known to have more than one. He taught us more than one. Even in ruku', there are more invocations taught to us by the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam than just the common Subhana Rabbi al-Azim. After Subhana Rabbi al-Azim, there are other invocations to allow our Salah and our worship to remain dynamic, where we have constant interest and we're not bored. Allahu Akbar. This is how our life should be. When we study, let's be dynamic in our study. Let's study through listening to audio, for example, and then study via reading from reading material. And then let us study by attending live lectures and sometimes online lectures. Let us study sometimes as individuals, and sometimes let us study as groups. This way, the process of study is dynamic and we don't become bored when we study. The same applies to our work and what we do in our work and how we do it. For example, when we train and go to the gym, for example, there's different exercise. We're dynamic in how we train ourselves. When we jog, for example, let us take different routes, for example, so that the process of jogging also remains dynamic and we have a special interest in doing it every day. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala created us and He knows us better than we know ourselves. And thus, He has made obligatory this salah in this fashion and in this manner, because He knows what keeps us interested and He knows what makes us bored. Let us learn from Salah and let Salah develop our character. I love you all for the sake of Allah. Until next time, Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.